Okay, guys, so remember these coasters? Well, I posted them on Kitty Cafe page. They were asking, you know, if people have been inspired whilst living in lockdown, and they commented, you know, oh, I want one. And I just thought, you know what, I'm going to make them all and maybe send them in. Okay, so I have lots of molds and pictures ready. This one. The one I want to start with. I've got a lot of resin here. I'm going to put my gloves back on because I can see me spilling it. Getting it all over my fingers. So, lift that up gently. The most amount of resin I worked with at one time. Okay, and in this one I'm going to pop, take the gloves off again, some of these polystyrene beads. I'm going to put that in now. Oh, let me just have a quick pop of some of those. Okay. In this one yet. Green. Static is just terrible. Right. I think that will do. Loose ones down. I'm not going to put too many in. Maybe a few more. Glitter to this. We can move this one out of the way. And I want a silver, I think. and I just want very small amounts, so we'll just do a little bit at a time. I think that's it, just that little bit, because this is going to be the front of these coasters. Okay, so what I'm going to do is add a layer, very thin layer, to each coaster. We'll have enough resin. Not quite sure why it's not going into this area. So we'll help it. Okay. You see how I've used some different shapes this time for the cat photos. Just thought I'd add a bit of interest, do something a bit different. Okay. this one. Been about 3 hours. It's still soft, but we can start adding the next layer now. So I'm going to add just a layer of the resin. This one was going in here, yes. Yes. So we just spread that out just a little bit. Unfortunately, I don't know the names of the other cats. Some of these photos are really old, so when they opened 2015, they're photos that I took. Okay, so I'm just gonna hit that heat gun. Pop that photo in. Push, try and get the air out. Just have a look. Yeah, that looks fine. I'm just going to add a little bit of resin on the top. Okay, that's that one. Out the way. Okay. this one. Dry. I think it's dry. I've just added these Tim Holtz words and I put a bit of a gloss varnish over the top just to protect the paper. Again, I'm just going to push it so any bubbles come out. Just making it worse. Stickers on Heathcliff's face. Well, not on his face, but let's pop that over there. Okay, now I've got a little bit of thinking to do with this one. Just got to get everything in the right place. Just take my glove off for a second. Now, this label. My pencils seem to have a point on them. Okay. a little think about this one. So I'm going to put my glove back on. Because I do not want to end up with sticky fingers again. Okay. Do you want to just heat that up? We're going to blow those stickers away, so let's lift it a little bit. Right. I'm just going to have a look underneath. Yeah. Okay. Just a double check. Yeah, that's fine. Just give it a little. In. Okay, a little bit of resin on top, that glove. This one's a smaller coaster, so it doesn't take as much. Okay, so let's hit that. Right, now. Before we put the picture on this one, right. Let's add some glitter. Should we stick with the? I think we'll stick with the purple and the green. So let me grab my box of goodies. So yeah, I'm going to add an extra layer of resin to this, just to smooth those bubbles out a bit. Now that they should hopefully stay in place a little bit now. And I should have used my little tool again. That'll do. Put a bit too much. As a background, so it's fine. Oh, that's fine. A little purple, maybe. Let's use this because I'm very heavy handed. Now, because these little polystyrene balls protrude, you see, and it makes very bumpy surface, so you just need a little bit extra on top. They kind of float a little bit, so I add a thin layer of resin to hold it in place, and then I add another layer to smooth it. Oh, it's messy. I'm so messy. Right. Get all of that out there. Gonna pop my lid back on the glitter before it gets everywhere. Let's add a little bit of heat. So I'm going to let that layer set. Oh, there's a bit there that's not got any of the resin in. There we go, got it. Try and let it even off. Yep, so I'll put that somewhere flat to dry. And I'll be back. Maybe tomorrow. So I've popped my photo in this one with some resin and added some little hearts, and I've decided what I want to use in each of the others. I've set that up. So let's move some stuff up here. Let's grab the cup. Again, I'm going to need quite a bit of resin. Gloves. Right. Okay, so all I want to do with this one is just pop a thin layer on the top just to seal any of those hearts in that are sitting on the top. That should do us. Just get droopy droop. Is that going to come off? Right, let's heat. It's a tiny bit chilly in here today, so the resin's very thick and bubbly, and yeah, just a bit of heat will help. I think that one is pretty perfect. So just pop her somewhere flat. I think I'm just going to pop this light on. I'm going to want to split some of this off. let's do this one first. We're going to pop all sorts of sequins on this one, I think. If I can get the lid off. Take the gloves off and I'll get the lid off. Okay, so I'm going to sprinkle. Sequins everywhere. Take this one off as well for a sec. There we go. So we've got purple stars, yellow stars. Blue stars. And these pinky purpley hexagons. It's been a while since I did maths, you know, at school when we learnt all the shapes and all that. It's excited. Okay, so I'll add a bit of resin. I'm not too worried about the placement at the moment because they'll probably move as I spread the resin and all that. Add a bit of heat. Tilt it a little bit. And then we can add some more if we want to. A lot of those hexagons are floating. I'm gonna grab my stick and just separate those. Let's have some more yellow stars. Just a few more blue ones, I think. Quite a few blue ones there. So let's shove that around a bit. Now, pop that somewhere to sit. Alright, let's move these bits out of the way. Just put them on top there for a minute. Now, I'm going to grab a cup. So what are we at? About 75. Let's clean that cup first. Let's grab some tape. And just go in there and grab out a mop. Time we on. Ooh. Yeah. I've got some bread in the slow cooker, so it does need checking, but I'm sure it will be fine. Right, so I'm gonna pop some of this in here. Okay, we'll see how we go with that. Let's do this one. And this one, I've got some little, they're like nail art flowers and, oh, they're like stars. Yeah, oh no, they are like flowers. Okay. Flowers, stars. Yeah. And try and get them. I'm not sure how this one's going to turn out because it looks like the image has sunk on one side but not the other. We'll see. They'll probably move, but we can move them again. A little bit of silver glitter for this one. Mix that. Let's warm that up a little bit. Hope the cup doesn't melt. It's moving. A little bit more, so let's pour that in. There we go, let's have a little bit of heat. Just push. A few of those flowers back out. Sorry if my head's in the way. There we go, lovely. Right. Gech resin. So. Again, we'll put that somewhere flat. Move that out the way. Move this one in. We'll do the same with this one. This one's little heart. If I can get in, hang on. Went everywhere. I know you won't be able to see most of this from the front, but that's okay. So, again, make sure this cup's clean. Yeah, that one's okay. Resin. little bit of gold glitter for this one. Do I need some more resin for this one? We'll soon see. And then grab the stick, that's fine. Move some of the hearts about. Right, and the last one is going to be a little bit of an experiment for me because I've never used alcohol inks before, and I think I want to grab green glitter. Right. We'll just go straight into here, I think. No, we won't. We'll go into here. Right. Now then, good mix. Oh, I like it. It's got the glitter. Only a little bit, hopefully. Here we go, let's have a look. Thank you. Right. Let's see. Might need a little bit more resin. Yeah, let's put drop more resin in. Ah, put my finger straight in it. Yes. Heat it again. There we go. I don't mind if it does stay a bit marbly, that's fine. Just added interest. So we'll put that somewhere for that. And now we've got some resin left over. So I'll just add a little bit more to this one. Bubble there. I'm just wondering if I can get the resin to go into it. Fill it up. Maybe. There we go. Can still see it, but maybe a little filler, I don't know. It's not too bad. So I think that's it. I'm gonna let them sit, and then what time is it? Hopefully. We'll pop those out soon. Been over 24 hours. And let's do the big reveals, shall we? Let's do this one first. That's a nice thick coaster. So it does need a little bit of filing at the bottom here, but other than that, how cute. Love it. Okay, so let's move that mold out a little bit. Which one next? Should we go for Heathcliff? Again. Needs a bit of work. I like it. So yeah, it just needs a bit of finishing off. Just sand off the rough bits because they're quite sharp. Yeah. Let's have a look at this one. some large bubbles in that one, unfortunately, but it's kind of cute. Hoping there's not too many bubbles in this one. Oh, yeah, there's a bubble right there. That's a shame. Let's get this one. That's really cute. So there we go. Feels a little bit tacky still. So I think my favourites are this one. And I think maybe this one. Quite like that. So thank you for watching. Please check out the Kitty Cafe's Facebook page, YouTube channel, and merchandise site, all of which I will link in the description below. So thank you for watching, and I hope to see you again soon.